Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you how you can set up a Zap, which will automatically create a Xero invoice when you confirm a deal in HubSpot, and it will take all of the line items that you've got in your deal and transfer them over into the invoice automatically. So let's jump in and we'll go through it. It looks like a really long Zap. You can see here it's got 16 steps, but most of these steps are internal Zapier formatter steps or other kinds of free steps for Zapier related actions. And so they're all orange here, so it gets a little bit confusing, but these ones are for HubSpot and these ones are for other kinds of free Zapier steps. And I'll go through it step by step so I can show you how it's done and you'll be able to easily do it yourself. Let me zoom in here and we'll start from the top. So we start with the step that triggers everything, which is the updated deal stage in HubSpot. So let me jump in and we'll edit this Zap so I can go into a little bit more detail. And I'll zoom in again. So basically we've got this trigger step here. We have the deals, the pipeline I've chosen. Well, let's start here. We've got HubSpot and then the event is update deal stage. I select my account. The trigger step is going to be when the deals pipeline that I've got here, the sales pipeline, and then the deal stage is equal to closed one. That's going to be the trigger. And then it's going to pull in all these details here from via Zapier from HubSpot. And then we've got our deal test deal here that we've got, that we pulled in the data from. Then it's going to use that information and pull in the associations. So I've already gone through this in quite a few other videos, so I'll link to some of those, or link to the main video there relating to associations and different objects in HubSpot. But basically we're going to use this step called find associations, and we're going to go into HubSpot and look at the deal ID and then find the related association. So this is the deal in HubSpot and we're looking up the related associations over here to the object, the contacts object and the person, the company's object and the company, and the line items object and the various line items. And so then we use the deal ID as a starting point and we let it know that it's the deal ID that we're using, the deal object. And then we're going to select the number of associations we want to search for. So in this case, we're searching for three, which is the company, the contact, and the line item objects. So then we click continue and we can test that and get these details here. So we've got this is the company ID. So for example, you can click on company and you can even see this in the URL. See, I'll just pop that down there. You can see it's just here. And then the same for the contact, and then the same for these line items like that. So it gets these data points, these numbers, these IDs, internal IDs. And then using that internal ID, we can then set up this HubSpot step get company. And then that's then looking at that company ID there, pulls in all these details from HubSpot like this. We then do the same for contact. So get contact. The same, the ID for the contact, all these details get pulled in. And then for the line items, because there are three in this case, sometimes you might have a deal which has one, two, three, you know, who knows how many. We need to set up a loop step in Zapier. So basically what a loop is it's going to just keep flowing through one by one. So there's one line item, goes through, it looks again, is there a second line item, goes through, is there a third line item, goes through, etc. You can see here. So this is called looping by Zapier. You select the event create loop from line items, because that's what we're going to be using to do this now. Under action, I'm calling this line item. Here I've typed this in. I've called this line item and then I'm looking up the deal to line item that we pulled out of this associations. And you can see here there's one, two, and three. You can see the little comma here. There are three line items in this deal. And then we go through and we can change this here, but I've set it to a maximum of 50, but I think it defaults to 500. So you can adapt that as you like. You don't need to change that, but I feel like 500 is definitely more than I need. So I just want to keep it a little bit closer to the number I'm expecting. So I've got 50 there and then continue and test, and it will pull in only the first one as an example when you do this. So it's not going to test all the loops. It'll just be the first loop that would go through. Then I've added in a delay step, And this is so that because looping actually runs all concurrently. So if you're doing three, it'll look at three at the exact same time. It doesn't like wait and do one, then the next, then the next. It'll do all three or, you know, however many straight away. And so we want to add a delay step here. And I'm adding in this delay step where I've set it up so that each loop iteration will be one, you know, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3 of a minute. So loop iteration one will happen faster than iteration two, iteration three, because it will naturally be 0.1 minute for the first one, 0.2 minute for the second one, 0.3 minute for the third one, etc. So that's why I've set this up like this, 0.1, and then I've set it for minutes. So this is basically creating an order for the loops, because as I said, the loops run concurrently normally. So they all happen all together normally. So you've got to be aware of that. So we've got that delay in there. And then we start the loop steps that we want to do. So we've got the line item step first. So this is HubSpot. The event is get line item. We set our action, line item action here, the line item ID. And this is from the loop step. So this will only show you the first one, as I said. Only the first one comes through when you do the test. So that's the correct one here, line item, and then the ID number there for that line item. It's going to pull in these other details for this line item based on that ID. It's come in, and then continue and test, and then this is the data that comes through for that line item. We're going to append key details. We're going to have three append steps using this Digest by Zapier, this free tool within Zapier. And essentially what we're doing is kind of saving this data for the later step where we're going to use it in the line item step in Xero to create our invoice. So we have this append entry and schedule digest step. And we've called this one, this first one, item name. And then it's going to save the name from step 7, which is going to be looping. So each time this loops, does the line item, finds the first line item, saves the item name, saves the item price, saves the item quantity, loops around, finds the next line item, saves that next item name, next item price, next item quantity, etc. So that's what this digest, it's like saving this sort of digest, like a feed of information. It's saving it here. And then importantly, we've got the frequency set as manual with pairing it to a release digest step like that. And to save time when you're setting this up, I suggest you click duplicate like this, and then it will automatically paste it below and you can just rename it so you don't get confused. So it's essentially the same thing, just changed each time. For example, here we've got price and I've added the price. So price name, I've added the price value here from step 7, line item step. And then the same again for quantity with the action step, same exact thing there for quantity. And then we have a filter step to stop the loop. So because loops are going to keep going forever and it will loop in everything below it as well. It won't keep going forever. Sorry, I should say it'll keep going for as many line items, but it'll flow down here and loop all the steps that follow. So we want to have a step here that kind of stops the loop from running. And we have this filter step. So the loop iteration is last is true. So only continue down the flow here, down the workflow, if the loop iteration is last. And so the last one, obviously. So that's why that one's there. That's an important step. And then we then release each of the digest steps. So we've been appending these three appending digest steps that I just went through, name, price, quantity. And then we have to release each of those steps here, name, price, quantity. And then what this is doing, so this is digest by Zapier again. The event is called release existing digest. We can see here, we select which digest we want. So item name, we've done the same here for item price and the same here for item quantity. And then you'll get this. In this example, in this test run, I just did it twice with the same data here. So you can sort of see what would happen. So we've got list one, line item one, line item two, like this. And then the same for price, same quantity. And then I've got this utility step. Actually, I don't need this step. So let me just remove that one here because we're getting data straight away from these. We don't need to do any cleaning up of that data. Basically, then we create our Xero step at the end. So we've got Xero. We select the event, create sales invoice, select our account. And then we select our organization, our company, you know, like ourselves, the contact name we want to send it to, which is coming from step 3, where we did our company search. So contact in Xero obviously means, usually means company. And then you've got the email address you want to send it to, like this, which is coming from our contact step up here, step four. So we've got our get company where we pulled the data from HubSpot, get contact where we pulled the data from HubSpot. So they're both coming into here. I'm saving this as a draft Xero invoice to start with. I've set the date that that we're creating the invoice as today, and the due date as today plus 14 days, like this. And then I've got, you don't have to set all these features here, but I've added the currency, I've selected my currency, I've selected my branding theme that I've got for this. I've skipped some of these other fields. I've added the reference ID, my internal reference ID, which is different than the invoice number. The invoice number is going to be automatically generated, but the reference ID is, I'm just using the deal ID from HubSpot because that's a unique ID that I can refer back to. I'm marking it not as sent, so as unsent, let's say. So it's sent to contact as false. And then importantly, we have our line items section here. So you can skip all these unless you really need to use them. And if you need to use them, then you'll need to adapt what I've gone through here. But basically I'm setting this up very simply in this example with description, which is the product name, quantity, the number, and then the price. And you can see from this release digest step, we've got this testing where we've got these two names in here, these two quantities in here. You can see the comma, this is the line item, and then the unit price line itemized as well with these two prices. And then I skip all the other sort of steps in this example. So if you wanted to go through this, it would take a bit longer. I don't want to go into too much detail, but if you have any issues doing any of these other steps, please let me know and I can cover that separately. And then we click continue and I test the step, which I've done before. And we end up with this invoice here. So this is invoice in Xero. We can see we've got the company that it's going to, the date, the issue date, the due date, so it's plus 14, it's automatically done that, created the invoice number automatically, got the deal ID as the reference, currency and branding is all correct, and then we've added our two items here, quantity, price, and the rest is just default information automatically added up. So you could even set this to automatically send, but I like it set as a draft, at least while we're first testing this out. And then that's it. So it looks tricky, but it's actually very straightforward. It looks long. In the end, it's actually 15 steps, but there's really only 1, 2, 3, 4 HubSpot steps, a loop step for HubSpot, and then there's 0 steps, and the rest are free Zapier formatting steps and other kinds of Zapier products, which are free as well. So it's quite simple. So give that a shot. Let me know if you've managed to make it work for yourself and if you have any questions about this. And if you have any ideas for how to make this even simpler and smoother, I'd love to hear them as well. It's always a bit tricky with HubSpot because of the way the associations work with line items. It can be really good, but it can also be a lot of extra steps in terms of these digests. So please make your comments below about any of the problems, questions, feedback you've got about this. I'd love to hear it. This has been useful for you. Please like the video and feel free to subscribe if you want to see more content like this. Thanks for watching. Look forward to seeing you in the next one. Cheers.